Hi, my name is Angela Huffman with quiltedjoy.com. I want to show you in this video tutorial how I organize and import large batches of digital patterns into my Intelliquilter and keep everything straight and organized. You'll need to be sure that you've watched my other video on how I use Evernote in tandem with this process. So Evernote is a free program. It's how I organize, tag, search, and find any digital pattern I need within seconds in my IQ. So go watch that video first that you're acquainted with Evernote, and then we're gonna come back and watch this video so that I can teach you how to use a different free program, one that's owned by Evernote, called Skitch, so that you can stay organized as you're manipulating your files. In this video tutorial, we're also gonna be using the StiQ program. Now, the StiQ is just the Intelliquilter program on a jump drive. If you do not own a StiQ, that's perfectly fine. At the end of the video, I'm going to show you how to do this process using only your tablet. So make sure you go watch that Evernote video and then come back and watch this one. I'm going to show you how to use Skitch with Evernote and the StiQ. It's going to make everything so simple. Skitch is a free program made by the same folks who make Evernote. You can find it at evernote.com/Skitch. We're going to move and sort a large set of digital patterns that I've imported into my IQ. First, we'll do this using the StiQ, but if you don't have a StiQ, we'll use a different method at the end of the video when you use your tablet only. From the main menu, click on Utilities, and then click Library Maintenance. We are moving our pattern files around, so select Pattern Library, select Move. They are sitting in my Downloads catalog. The first thing I need to do is drag up on the workspace to make my thumbnails of my imported patterns as small as I can. Now I'll use the screen snap button in Skitch to give me some crosshairs to select the portion of the screen I want to snap. I'll click on Capture, which will enter this picture into the temporary memory of Skitch. I won't be keeping this photo, I'm just using it for reference of the patterns that I will be working on. I'm doing this so I can strike through each thumbnail as I catalog it into Evernote, which will keep me from getting confused. Let's select all the borders and corners and click Move. We do not want to keep a copy of the files in this catalog. Now we're ready to bring them into Evernote. Back out to the main menu and select Utilities and View Print Patterns. Click on Borders and Corners. The first pattern we moved, according to the screenshot I took with Skitch, is entitled Festive Hearts. I'll navigate to that pattern and select it. Click on Select, and the pattern comes up full screen. Now I'll use the Evernote Web Clipper to take a screen clip. Notice that by doing this, the screen clip automatically includes the information as to which catalog this pattern is located within and what its name is. I won't have to enter that information in Evernote. It's done for me. Once it is in Evernote, I can tag it. Let's tag it IQ, flower, and border. Now, over in Skitch, I just slash through that thumbnail to show I've processed and cataloged that pattern in Evernote. Now we can do another one. Select the pattern in the StiQ, grab it with Evernote, tag it, slash through it with Skitch. This is how I keep from getting confused as to which patterns I'm working on when doing batch import cataloging. If you don't have the StiQ, your process will be a little different. You'll use the tablet to take a snapshot of the download folder screen from your tablet using the last soft key at the top of your tablet if you're using one of the i500 tablets. If you have a different style tablet, you may need to press a different soft key to take a screenshot. Just press and hold. You'll see a little camera icon confirming you took a screenshot. Take a screenshot of every page of your downloads folder and save the screenshots to your USB drive. Then just bring those screenshots into Skitch so you can slash through the thumbnails as you move and catalog each pattern to keep from getting confused. Thanks for watching. Please visit quiltedjoy.com and take a look at our blog and our online store. I'd love to see what you're working on. Join me over on Facebook and join the conversation. And be sure to subscribe to this YouTube channel so you're notified every time a new video is posted.